Welcome back, Trainters. Ludo here with another fabulous, informative episode of Pokemon Go, and today starts our Pride adventure. So, kind of got behind because of Pride Week and work. So, I've been behind on editing. There's been a lot of news in the Pokemon Go world. We have trading now, for one. Regice is another new, the only now new legendary raid boss. Kyogre is gone. The Water Festival is now officially over, but starting now, literally right after this video, it'll probably be linked right up there, is gonna start the Pride weekend and the Water Festival vlogs. I apologize for getting behind, but I had a lot on my plate during these last 2 weeks, prepping for Pride, and then doing stuff with work, and then doing stuff with my YouTube, so I was super packed. So without further ado, you can click here to start watching telling you, I'm still trying to come off of all of this stuff, so. But you can click there to see the first episode, but for now, we're just gonna talk a little bit about how trading works and goes. One, you have to be, right now, level 40 in order to do any of the things from the new update that is out. Don't know the new update, you should have been informed. You know me, I am always behind. I do not really do update news videos because by the time that I actually get out or up to do them, everybody's already got like their fifth video on it out. So Pokemon Go themselves are quite informative on their notifications as well lately. So with that, we have discovered that, like they did when they released the raids, they're doing it in a level tiering, just so that way they can smooth out the bumps and figure out all the problems that could be involved with the new update before it's just widespread and everybody has it. So yes, I was super butthurt, kicking the balls, like, when I was like, oh my god, there's the friends list, must be level 40 to have this Oh, she really came that way? I was like, you know, and there has been a lot of complaints on the internet about this, but I understand it. It is a total butthurt, but I understand it. With that being said, there are already people out there who are making videos of getting their Alolan egg, trading Pokemon, making new friends. So super exciting times are ahead of us in Pokemon Go. I'm super excited for it. So the minute that I can, you know, actually get my thing going, I will, you know, start adding you guys as friends. We can start building a friendship. We can figure out how to do some trades and whatnot. But for now, we're all, unless you are level 40 yourself, we're all just gonna have to sit and wait. And then last thing, there is a new giant Pokemon Go Summer Tour 2018 event going on in the game. You can, I will leave the link down in the description. I personally have not read up so much on it myself, but it basically goes along the lines of how they did Chicago Fest last year, in that when we, outside of the event, did certain things, it unlocked things for them in the event there, which then by them completing those unlocked stuff for us globally. So again, it's this kind of same idea where they're taking the different kind of regions and the different kind of events that are going on through Summer 18, and through completing certain tasks, we will unlock rewards. And then once everybody on all those regions have completed tasks, there'll be a end summer gigantic reward, basically. You can see on the thing here. But the link will be down in the description. I haven't read it so much myself, so I'm gonna go do, you know, a favor for myself and read it myself, as you probably should as well. But that's it for that. And then last, Squirtle is announced for July Community Day. And we all kind of predicted that when we saw Hydro Cannon come in, and everybody's like, well, what's that move? That's a move for a starter. So we kind of all knew. Plus, if you've watched any of Famous's videos, I will link him down in the description as well. He had a very good, very well thought out predicted, theorized, and constructed video on how they are predicting through to next summer of the Pokemon that are going to be featured in Community Days. And Squirtle was, of course, the next one that was predicted. A lot of people had that one in mind as well, but of course it was right. We have Squirtle, and everybody is hoping and praying to the Niantic gods and Arceus that we get a Squirtle Squad Squirtle. Like, I don't even know how to express to Niantic, because they don't watch me, but for real, like, if you don't do that, Niantic, it is literally, at this point, because we've made it so apparent that's what we want, and it's so important to the story and the nostalgia of it. If you don't give us Squirtle Squad Squirtle, you're literally doing it just because you don't want to at this point. All tea, all shade, no pink lemonade. So get excited. As I already said, there are so many great things coming in Pokemon Go. All the links will be down in the description. This was just a video to let you know I have been on hiatus. I have been editing, though, on this hiatus. So get to watching the episodes. The Water Festival, Pride Weekend, and the end of the Water Festival are coming. And we will see you down in the comments. We'll see you in the next video. And I will see you when we make friends in exchange for our next actual real life trade in Pokemon Go. Oh my god. Super exciting. Scroll down. Give me that like. Maybe consider subscribing if you're not. And if you are subscribed, be sure to hit the notification button next to the subscription button so that way you're notified of the next adventure. And we'll see you then, trainers. Bye.